what that music means. 5:19 Wednesday, that means it's time for another Maine Mystery. This, the third and final story in this month's series, and Katie's gonna tell us the tale behind how a town in western Maine became abandoned, right?
That's right, let's get started. In the 1940s, Flagstaff Plantation was a bustling town heavily involved in the logging industry. But by 1950, everyone was forced to leave. And what became of the town makes it very hard for visitors to return there.
You probably see a big farm that just before we got into town. And there was a little houses on the left.
Where you and I see Flagstaff Lake, June Parsons sees the town where she grew up.
Just to the right of that little island.
That's because beneath the surface of this man-made lake lies the drowned ghost town of Flagstaff Plantation. June lived in Flagstaff until she was 13 years old.
My father owned a store, and we lived out in the back. That was my bedroom window.
But in 1950, Central Maine Power Company flooded the plantation and several surrounding towns to make way for a hydro dam.
Because they were making a storage dam for water, a storage basin for water.
Families were forced to sell their homes and businesses to the power company, then pack up and leave. Many moved to neighboring towns just outside the flood zone.
Where we were. Stratton, this is where we are.
June's family relocated to Eustis, where she still lives.
And I thought it was exciting because we were moving, but I was a kid.
But not everyone shared June's outlook.
Usually you can go back to the town that you lived in.
Across the town of Eustis, Betty Wyman fondly remembers her childhood home in Dead River, which neighbored Flagstaff. But memories are all she has now.
I can't take my children back and show them where I grew up, where I lived when I was young. The house is no longer there. So wherever it was is underwater.
But if you know where to look in Eustis, you can find pieces of Flagstaff all over. The majority of buildings and some pieces of others were razed and moved outside of the doomed town line. Today, you could still find the schoolhouse, the church windows, even the bodies and gravestones from the Flagstaff and Dead River cemeteries, all residing in their new home. The house that June lives in was also saved.
So this is the house I'm standing in right now?
Yes.
That's amazing.
But there were some who didn't settle with Central Maine Power Company before the water rose.
Some people refused to sell and they just part of them anyway.
And then the water just came up around them and just kept working them and they finally just fell apart.
Whatever is left of the abandoned town of Flagstaff now lies at the bottom of the lake of the same name, almost 50 feet down at its deepest. But for one-time locals like June, the memories still bring the sight of the ghost town back to life.
Now it sticks in your mind. You can picture where things were.
If you know a legend or a mysterious story that happened in your area, let me know about it. You can tweet me, Facebook message me, or just plain regular email me.